All right.
I can't believe it.
Yo, what up, what up, what up? Welcome back to Pinoy News. Man, listen, I'm here with Willie Cogley. We're going to talk some cars today because, like, you know, I'll be honest with you. The price of cars is just gone. It's out of this world at this point, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, Willie, yo, want to say what up to the crowd?
What's up, what's up? Same old, same old.
Same old, same old. All right, so, like, basically, what we're going to do is we're going to, like, stand here and, like, go over. We're going to kind of, like, go through Craigslist and check out some of these cars and, like, how much they cost. Because the used car market over the past 2 years has, like, just gone fucking insane. Like, the average price of a used car now is something like $45,000. Like, and that's used. That's not a new car. That's used. Right? So, Willie, you know what I'm saying? You ready to rock?
Let's do this.
All right. Let's get down to business, right? So, all right, first up on the list. God damn it, motherfucker. All right, first up on the list, a Ford F-450, right? This is like a 2000, and I want to say like 2014 Ford F-250 or F-450.
If that comes with the trailer, that's insane.
It doesn't come with the trailer. It's just a truck.
That's insane.
Yo, $27,500 fucking dollars for this fucking truck, man. Used, right? Then we got a 2005 Honda Accord for $5,500, right? Now, when you really think about this, this is a 17-year-old car.
I bought cars like that for $300.
Oh, I feel you.
They shouldn't be that. Is that really almost 10 grand
for a 2013 Volkswagen Jetta Sports Wagon TDI?
Oh my god.
$10,000 fucking dollars. For a 2013. It's 9 fucking years old.
How many miles are on it?
I don't fucking know. We're not going to click on it.
You don't want to get no viruses.
Well, it's not just that. I don't feel like fucking like going through the rigmarole, right? Well.
The Mercedes C300. Yeah, I worked on the. Whoa.
$25,000.
Yeah, no, that's much. That's a lot.
Yeah, that's a lot of bread. That's a lot of bread. I mean, yeah, like, you know.
I would say that car, honestly, is probably worth 10? All right, now that's actually worth something.
I mean, it's a 68, right?
Yeah, look at it. It's all there. The bed's on it. It looks like it was replaced.
It looks like it's primered up. You know, I mean, it's primered up in the back and primered up in the front and rusted. It got a good patina to it.
It looks different.
It got a good patina.
It's not a matching vehicle. I'd give that thing probably $4,500, depending if it runs or not.
Yeah, that's kind of where I was thinking too. It was like about $4,500, $5,000, right? Yo, 2008 Jeep Wrangler.
Fuck that thing. I don't even want to look. Wait, they went $17,000 for
$17,000 fucking dollars, dude.
That is not right.
Yo, $17,000.
What year is that? 2008? Yeah, no. No, yeah, we skipped that. We got for the Porsche, yeah. $55,000. Screw that thing.
Yo, $56,000.
Yeah, that's insane. No.
Yo, who the fuck is paying $56,000 for a 2014 fucking Porsche? That car is worth 20 grand. Top end.
You can get them for 20 grand.
I know. Right.
No, that's actually. All right, so what do they want for the. I mean,
plow and the spreader with it for $6,000. That's not bad.
It's a Salter and has a plow on it. I mean, you could make your money with that, but. It's a Ford. The thing's probably going to blow up on you as soon as you get it.
Yo, $7,500 for a 2014 Ford Fiesta.
Oh, my God. I hate this.
What? It wasn't worth $7,500 when they made it.
Well, what happened to that's the problem with the used car market. Everything is skyrocketing, and all you got, all your options are, is junk.
Yo,
you don't have an option for good vehicles because they're all fucking sold immediately.
A 2012 Jeep Patriot 4x4 Sport.
For $9,000.
For $9,000. And that's got to be high mileage too, right? For $9,000. legit.
It probably has 150,000 on it, 140.
Yeah. 2012 Jeep Cherokee Laredo, fucking 4x4. Yo, Laredo really doesn't mean a fucking thing. $12,000.
Oh my god.
10-year-old vehicle, $12,000.
Dude, those are junk. The Kia.
The Kia Sorento.
Right there, the Kia Sorento. I worked on a bunch of them. They had the ones that had the four-cylinder in them. Like, if you pull the valve cover off, they have a horrible issue with sludging up. And then it burns the heads up because the valve springs get messed up.
Well, part of it's the fucking fact that, like, the motherfuckers, people who own Kias don't change their fucking oil.
Change the oil.
They're poor.
And they put the cheapest oil in there.
And they use Fram filters and shit. You know, it's just junk.
Dude, you're right.
Yeah, I know.
You're right. They're like, oh, it calls for synthetic, and they put like, oh, I'm just gonna put like cheap ass conventional in.
Yo, they're just dumping dollar store oil in it and shit, right?
Yeah, it doesn't even have an SAE rating on the back.
Yeah. Right. All right.
That's like
a 2014 Chevy Equinox.
Yeah, I worked on too many of those to want to buy one.
Yo, look, seriously.
10 grand.
Yo, number one, you shouldn't even buy this car as a whole. Just as an injection.
I wouldn't buy it. Right? I wouldn't even buy it at all. Yo, same thing with that. The Ford? Nope. I wouldn't touch that with the 10-foot pole.
Fuck no. It's a piece of shit. Right. There you go. We got to get to
the Malibu's budget. Not bad. What the fuck?
1997 Ford. 1990, I don't care how much those tires and rims are worth, right? Let's say you got you have a $250 set of spacers on it, right? Probably $3,000 in rims, some really nice fucking meaty tires, right? And a nice paint job, but you know you're not.
Right, actually.
Yo, it looks nice, but I'll be real, it's not worth $15,000. It's a 97.
Nowhere near. It probably has a freaking 351 in it.
Right.
Either that or a 7.3.
Yo, it's a 97.
No, it does have a 7.3. It's in the description.
Yeah, it's a 7.3. But yo, it's a 97. Yeah. For $15,000.
I'd give it. Oh, God. Just skip that one.
What the fuck is a Terrazza? I didn't even know this car was made.
It's a Traverse. It's pretty much a Traverse. Or an Equinox. No, that one I think is an Equinox. It's on the Equinox chassis. It's pretty much a fucking Equinox.
Yep. 2018 Honda Clarity plug-in hybrid.
You're making me smoke more.
Yo, $27,000.
I'm looking at the number. You're making me smoke more.
Right? Yeah. 2014 Toyota Prius plug-in hybrid hatchback four-door green. $18,000. $19,000.
This is why God doesn't talk to us.
Yep. Hey, we're going to get down to some more ridiculous shit, right? Because, like, yo, there's some doozies in here. Legit. All right. 2013 Porsche Boxster. $52,500. $20,000. A 2013.
That's the actual price for it? Oh my God.
Yo, $2,000 for a fucking Chrysler 300. That's actually probably not bad. Oldsmobile Alera.
Did you know it's junk?
$3,200 for a fucking Oldsmobile Alero.
That's insane. You know that car is junk.
Yeah. 2010 Civic, Honda Civic. $10,125.
That's more than the car was freaking brand new.
You're not wrong. Well,
okay, it's probably close. It's marginal.
Yeah.
It was a nice heavy truck. I don't like the wheels.
$26,000.
How much?
$26,000.
Oh my god. Fuck. Fuck. I can't look at it. Scroll away from that.
1998 Ford F-150 single cab, right? Like the fucking, the normal regular cab, right? No fucking extension on it, right? $6,900, $7,000.
Dude, you know the frame's gone on that.
Yeah, you know, like the entire truck is basically gone on this. And it probably got like a 5 liter in it. It don't even add to 5.8.
Or either that or the 5.4. Yeah. And with a million miles. See, the Cavaliers aren't that bad.
It's a 2003 for $5,000.
For $5,000?
Yeah.
Did you, I used to be able to get those for $100.
Yo, 2016 Chevy Silverado, 2500 crew cab, 4x4. 45,000. Yo.
That's nuts.
$45,000.
That's insane. That's insane money for a used
7-year-old truck.
Yeah, is it a diesel? Is it fucking, was done to it? Is there anything in the RAM? They won probably close.
42,000 for a 2012.
Yeah, that thing can freaking sit on the railroad tracks.
Yeah. 44,000 for a GMC Sierra. 2015.
It's insane, dude.
Right? Like, look at this shit.
You're better off getting an old beater and fixing the freaking thing.
2013 Sierra 2500 crew cab.
$40,000.
2011 Ford F-350 Super Duty, $14,000.
You know that thing's got a ton of miles on.
Oh, yeah. 100%. Yo, $5,000 for a Chevy Spark 1.2 liter. But it is a manual. It is a manual.
I took those to the demo derby. For $50.
Yo, 2012 GMC Sierra 1500 four-wheel drive, $16,000.
You know, that's actually not as bad as the other ones. What are they fucking selling a limo?
Yeah, there's a limo.
Okay, no, I want to look at that. Is that a fucking Lincoln Town Car?
Yeah, Lincoln Town Car. Right.
Oh, five? Oh, you know that thing fucking 120-inch
stretch
changed.
Five-door limousine by Federal.
12,000. And brake lines and all kinds of stuff.
2018 Chevy 1500 double cab LT 5.3 liter V8. Right? $27,000.
That's the flex fuel. That's not even the good 5.3.
Yeah, I feel you. Like, I have the original Vortec joint, the fucking the 2004. It's not bad, I'll be real. Yeah. All right, check this out.
Dude, save that motor.
2011 Toyota RAV4, the little itty bitty motherfucker. $12,500.
I got one in my backyard.
2010 Chevy Silverado 1500. $18,500.
That's fucking nuts. Dude, that's like a $6,000, $7,000 truck. I wouldn't give it any more than that.
1990.
Wait, whoa. Don't.
Well, I'm skipping over.
Are you
over.
Fucking kidding me?
No, go back down.
Go back down to the Corvette.
Oh, to the Corvette? Yeah, we can go to the Corvette. I'm with that. Hang on. Corvette. 12,000. All right, so
1990 Corvette. That one has the L98 in it. 230 horsepower, 340 for pounds of torque.
Yeah. I'm still not paying $13,000 for a fucking 1990 car. I don't care.
No, I wouldn't pay that. Fuck you. I wouldn't pay that at all.
There's another one.
It's like
$13,000 for another one in white.
No.
Oh, get the fuck. Get fucked. 2007 Pontiac Solstice. Fuck out of here for $17,000.
Oh my god. It's a freaking Cobalt on steroids.
Yo, it's a G8 with two seats.
Dude, it's not even a G8.
It's a G6.
It's a Cobalt on steroids. They got the battery in the freaking fender.
Yo, it's such a piece of shit. 17,000. Okay,
now that's cool. How much they want for that?
17 grand.
That's too much.
I mean, it looks like it's in good shape, though, right?
It looks nice, but you know it has a 305 in it.
I mean, it's a nice
It might have a 350, but it's a 76. That's a smog era. That thing's going to be a wimp.
You're gonna need the motherfucking. Oh yeah, you're gonna have to redo. You're gonna have to pull a motor out with LS in it. But like,
and you gotta redo the fucking seats. Heads on it, up the compression.
Yeah. Oh, it's a five. It's a 5-speed. Gears.
Is this stick?
You see the stick?
That's an automatic.
No. That's a stick.
No, that's an automatic.
No. That's a stick, dude.
Those Corvettes.
It had the gated shifter on that,
where they went back and forth.
No, it had the
gated. Do you see the fucking gear indicator next to it?
I do see the compartment. I'm telling you, I think that's a gated. Yeah, you might be right. I think that might be a fucking automatic. God damn it. Yeah, it's not even worth it. It's a fucking automatic. Like, fuck that.
Dude, you're not going to, in 76, there's very, very few 4-speed fucking Corvettes. Now, that's cool. No, I would rock that.
I'd drive it all day, but for $32,000,
that's that amount of money.
Yeah, for $32,000, let's keep it a buck, all right? You can get a new fucking Corvette C8, right?
Dude, my Caprice makes that much horsepower.
Yo, the mid-engine Corvette's only $58,000.
The fucking mid-engine Corvettes are brutal.
Right? Yo. A Volvo. A fucking Volvo.
50 grand?
50 fucking.
That'd be 50 grand by the time you're done with taxes.
And tags. Plus insurance and all the bullshit.
Yeah, no, just keep going.
Fuck out of there. Yo, get the fuck out of here. 28 grand?
God.
Come on.
Be gone.
Yo.
That's a joke.
Hold up.
Oh, that's cool. 32,000? That's not bad.
That isn't bad. I mean, like, okay.
No, that looks badass. I don't like the wheels.
I don't either. I love
the grill. But that's sick.
It's a coupe, too. Like, that. Like, it's I'll bet sick. You could flip that for a whole lot more.
Dude, you put a nice set of, like, Kreger's on it or something, and you make it, like, put the red line tires on it. And, you know, like...
I mean, like, I'm not sure, like... I know out in Cali, they would pay top dollar for that, right? Like, they drop it and bag it, put some Daytons on it and shit.
It probably is bagged. Look at the way it's sitting in the rear.
No, that's the natural. No, they got the fucking hub, they got the wheel cover on the back. Fucking, like, the wheel's meant to sit inside. Is that not GTO?
No, I mean, look at how low it is in the wheel well. It's dropped. It's either bagged or it's dropped.
Maybe I don't think it's like actually low. I think like it actually has like a wheel cover. Or I think like maybe it's like fucking like the wheel arch is actually lower.
Yeah, there's a shroud on the wheel well.
Yeah,
but yeah, that's natural.
Yeah,
but that car has been dropped.
Yeah, I mean,
it's like 13-inch Daytons. That's cool as hell.
Look at this little MG.
I'll put a small block in that little myth.
You said, yo, you said, let me put a 327 in that motherfucker. Like, yo, what the
smoke? I'll put a 350 in it. Fuck it.
Yo, man, listen, there ain't fitting a 350 in that bitch. It's too small of a car.
How much? Wait, they want fucking $17,000 for that little turd?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. Plymouth Fury.
Oh.
12 grand.
That's cheap.
It probably has a 318 in it.
No. I bet you it has like a fucking. I bet you it has a six
cylinder. 383.
No, it has a six cylinder in it. $100 says it has a six cylinder for 12,000.
I don't know. I don't got $100. I got like $8 in the bank account. Mm. Yo, look at that's fucking cool.
I never liked those, but like, yeah, I feel where you are.
Right. They're different.
I feel you, right? And it's cheap. Cheap as fuck.
See, they were kind of cool, too.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not a big Ford guy, right?
I'm not. No, that thing. What do they want for the Riviera? Oh, my God. That's... Are you fucking kidding me? That's more than the car was brand new from the factory.
I don't think. Right? I think new from the factory is probably about 17 or 18. Because it is the Buick Riviera. But, like... That is not worth $10,000.
Dude, do you know that thing? What year is it? 89? So it has a 3.4 in it, probably?
Probably. No. 3.8. It has a
3.8.
No, it has a 3.8 liter 6 in it.
Oh, the, yeah, the 3,800.
That's, yo, I'll be real. Like, let me keep this 100. If I had a lot of money, I might buy it just for the motor.
Those motors run.
I love those motors. That is my favorite motor of all time. Matt, yo, dude. $6,500 for a 2007 Volvo XC90. Yo, that thing gotta have like a trillion miles on it. Yo.
How much you want for that Mustang?
$9,000.
Oh, fuck.
Right.
Like, yo, it's a 4.6 in that thing. Yo. It's a Grand Marquis motor.
Yo, 1500 ramp. Oh, 2014 1500 ramp, $18,000.
These are nuts with this.
I told you.
Like, I didn't expect it to be. All right, what do they want for that old Ford truck?
$32,800.
There is a fight outside.
There's a what? There's a fight?
A fight outside.
Yeah, I don't care about your fight. Right, I don't care. 1995 Ford.
Almost $33,000 for a fucking 95 Ford F-250. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say, man.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, that's reasonable, $5,800 for a 2008.
That's reasonable.
Dodge.
They're showing off the rotted Dodge.
Yeah, no, they're like, you know, yo, we're gonna be real. We're gonna be real with you. Like, this thing is a piece of shit. Like, yo, just.
Oh yeah, you know that thing's a pile.
2008 Ford. Why is a 1995 same truck? Why is a 1995 motherfucking 34,000 and the 2008's 19,000?
Because that's a 5.4 in it, and they probably changed the spark plugs and had a bunch of freaking shrapnel go down the freaking holes when they tried pulling the plugs out.
Thank you.
I've done that. I have fixed Fords.
$12,000 $12,000 for a 2012 Chevrolet Volt. There's something desperately wrong with that car for $1,200. Yo, 2006 Subaru Legacy. Yo, Subaru Legacy Outback, $8,500.
It's they're good vehicles, dude.
No, they're not. They're shit. The old ones were really good. The night. All right, listen. No. All right, the '90s fucking Legacy wagons or the '90s fucking Outbacks, right? Were amazing. They were fucking like the best cars ever.
You couldn't kill them.
Yeah, but the 2000s ones were fucking junk. Legit. I'll be real. Like, I know four people who had them. All of them had the transmissions replaced. Motors were fucking giving up the ghost on the timing chains and shit. They were jumping time. They were just
fucking trash. That's the problem that a lot of people had with the suppose, is as the timing chain. If you don't change the oil, and you have to change the timing chain every 75 or 100,000 miles.
Yeah, like legit, like, and they, but like, you know, these are like old people who had these.